accepted goodbye stormily. As my husband and I were driving home, a blazing sunrise was right before us. And this is when I realized that goodbye by no means means the end. Just as that beautiful moon and that gorgeous sunrise assured me that Mom had passed through the gates of heaven, I know that her words and her virtues will remain alive in our lives every day. My mom was a simple woman with a determination to provide a good life for her family. And at the time, that meant she had to join our father in the workforce. But simply having a job and bringing in a paycheck was not my mother's way. When she committed, she was all in. It was that strong mindset that resulted in her enrollment in college courses. And motherhood was not by no means a roadblock for her. She would pack up my younger brother Mark with his workbooks and his crayons and tell him along to her evening classes. She set the precedence that education was important and it helped set your path in life. In a time where women were not paid the same salary as men and given the same respect, she would prove that she deserved all of that. My mom was a very frugal woman, but was able to create the most magnificent masterpieces out of discarded items. We can still hear her every Saturday morning, just one more yard sale and then we can go to the beach. But it was those weekly yard sale adventures that turned our summer beach house into a comfortable haven where our family could gather. She didn't just create a summer house, she created a home with a lot of memories for her children and their children. Those yard sale treasures also allowed our mother to become a master in tinkering. She restored furniture, she made curtains, she made slip covers and pillows. And she fixed lamps. In fact, her lamp tambourine has left us with quite a collection. Does anybody need a lamp? She spent a lot of time at her summer house in Rhode Island, and one of the things that she truly enjoyed was going to see the musicals at the Theater by the Sea with my dad and her family. She always came home talking about how talented some people were and how much she appreciated them sharing their talent with everybody at that beautiful place. She was also a very faithful woman. Her church attendance was important to my mother. And just like everything she did it with a passion. Anyone who ever attended Mass with my mom will forever remember that my mom sang joyfully, the hymns, but out of tune. And I can proudly say that she has passed that unharmonious confidence down through the generations as I see it today in myself, my daughters, and my grandchildren. But most of all, her heart was big. To let anyone needing a helping hand, she was there, be it taking into her home the son of a friend or caring for them as she battled cancer. She truly cared. She instilled that sense of caring into her children, assigning each of us a night to spend with Meme. And to this day, I can still hear the sound of the cowbell as Meme would beckon us to her bedside. This has come full circle because in her later years, my mom needed help to stay in her house. Our friend Penny was always there for her. My nephew Eric and his girlfriend Jenny moved in. My brothers Kenny and Mark spent many a night overnights with her. My brother Ricky had Thursdays and I had Mummy Mondays. So even though she is no longer here, our physical life, her words and her way of life have formed us into the people we are today. And her legacy will continue with me, with Rick, with Kenny, and with Mark, and with all the great-great-grandchildren and great-grandchildren. We wish you, Mom, but you have left an imprint and it will continue to guide us.